I tend to eat when I am upset. I would eat for comfort, and it is what started the journey of gaining the weight. I've had a battle with weight, started in my 20s, and the ball started rolling when I was having children. It kind of crept up until I was well over 280 at my highest. I was in pain a lot, especially on my lower extremities, my feet and my knees. Climbing upstairs was painful. Getting up and down from chairs was painful. Basically, I destroyed my gallbladder. In 2009, I had to have that removed. My boys growing up, they didn't have a mom that could run out and play with them, throw a ball, go play basketball or something, you know, that they like to do. I was pretty much indoors most of the time. It affected my marriage and our relationship. You learn to live with things, unfortunately, but it really affected my life and family. My journey with weight loss began after my spiritual journey. God had released a lot of misconceptions about Him and who He was and His faithfulness in my life. And I was learning and loving Him. And all of a sudden, I just got this real hunger and faith to believe that maybe this time it could work. If I just stepped out in faith and believed that He would meet me and I could actually do it. As I learned the way to eat more healthy. I eat a lot more fruits and vegetables in my diet. There's a lot of sneaky things in foods, that processed foods especially are there. So I read labels, try to stay away from things that have a lot of additives. I have learned to juice and drink green smoothies, trying to get as much green into my diet as possible. I still have a treat now and then, but it's not the overriding factor in my life. It's not something that I know if I don't have it today that I'll never have it again. All those fears that I used to have, I've put to rest. Grace was such the divine enablement behind why this time worked and the rest of the times that I had tried in the past failed. God has been faithful to me. He has been with me every step of the way. Many people were asking me how I was doing it, you know, whether I'd lost 20 pounds or 50 pounds. And one day I was sitting in my room and my husband came in and said, "You should start a blog." I didn't realize how much of a love that I would have. It's almost like a passion that I have to write. And it started out with writing my weight loss journey. Regret is sneaky, and it will pop in at any given moment if I'm having a low point. The regrets that I have are, they're honest feelings. And so I'll bring them before the Lord and turn them back around to remembering what He has done and the redeeming qualities that He's brought to my life. I want people to know that this journey is every day, but God's grace will help them through the day. I press on to have a healthy body and healthy mind, healthy spirit. I want to know God more, and it's all related to me, that whole body, because God created me, body, soul, and spirit. He's a redeeming God, so He will take things in your body, your physical self, and he can recreate them. If you give them the proper nutrients with His power behind it, there's nothing that can hold you back. I'm able to do things now that I haven't done in 25 years. My blood pressure is down, my high cholesterol is down. I still have things that I'm going through, but it's so much better than what it was before. Pretty much most of my life, I had a mindset of I can't. It would be the first thing that came into my mind. If someone suggested to do something, I would say, "Oh, I can't do that." It affected my entire life, from where I worked to what my body looked like to what I believed God for. And when I came into the relationship with the Lord that I discovered through my spiritual journey, He took those words and said, you know, turn them around, because you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. If I hear I can't do that, I immediately nip that in the bud and say, no, I can't. It didn't come overnight for me. It's going on 6 years now from my journey. Believe in the power of God. Believe in the grace of God. Believe that He's faithful and that He will do it. And let go of trying to do it yourself, and let Him come in and say, "Okay, help, let me help you with this." If you will allow Him to do that, He will come and be faithful to you.